parts, again, I'll go back to what I talked about earlier. One of the key issues is getting more Indian scripts. Thank you. Getting more Indian scripts onto the DNS. And we are looking to the business community because they are the front, you know, the consumer-facing, you know, organizations, the business community who actually deliver content, whether it's on your mobile phone, whether it's on a website. So we are looking for them to start participating more for with their inputs to create the rule sets for the various Indian languages. If you think of if you consider the fact that there are 22 official Indian languages. So just to give you a very small example, if you are going to spell a word like Akshar, how should it be spelled? You know, what are the letters? Can it be spelled in two different ways? Or should it be spelled in one single way? Because if you're going to have a Daksha.com, you don't want that there to be any confusion. Okay? So the business community needs to bring in their inputs with other communities and do this. So as Mr. Jayesh mentioned, also mentioned, we work in a multi-stakeholder community in total, and everybody needs to participate in this process. But in particular, we need the business community, which hasn't participated so much so long, to come to the table. Thank you.
Any questions?
Stakeholder base. Jayaron has already mentioned the numbers in terms of how many newcomers came to this meeting. I think the number is 1981, and most of them would be from India or at least from the APAC region for sure. The other thing is keeping the fact that India currently is the second largest internet user in the world. I will talk in more particular terms about some specific outreach programs we had designed uniquely for Indian participants. So the first one we did was, in fact, on the 5th of, the first one I'm talking about, it was held on the 5th of November, where Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad was also present, and it was organized by CII. Again, full house, over 120 odd people who attended. And essentially, it was to discuss why Indian business stakeholders should take part in internet governance issues. And I'll let my colleague Santosh later speak about, perhaps what the message the secretary had for the Indian, the Indian business stakeholders. On the 7th of November, we did a specific session, which was hosted by the ISP and CP. So ISP, Internet Service Providers, and Connectivity Providers, ISP-CP, constituency of ICANN. And in that, we involved both the Cellular Operators Association of India, which is COAI, and ISPI, which is Internet Service Providers Association of India. Again, we had a house full of local participants, including speakers from both the COAI and ISPI. And the issue there was, what we called it was Connect with What's Next. companies, clients, and connectivity. And where we were discussing, or what was discussed there, was particularly about what is the role ISPs play in the ever-changing world of internet and technology. You know, so everything ranging from security issues, from DNSSEC, which is related to security, and new GTLD programs, etc. All of those issues were covered. On the same day, we had another event, which the Internet and Mobile Association of India, which is IMAI, kind of co-hosted. And that was very specific to the Indian language or the Indian scripts. If you attended the opening of the of ICANN 57, you must have heard Minister Prasad, Ravishankar Prasadji, talking about the fact that how do we get more Indians using local language, on the internet, and we. Working with IMAI, we brought all the stakeholders in that ecosystem into that room. So we had people who actually developed local Indic fonts. We had people who were stakeholders who developed content in local languages. We also had our own experts who work on these issues of, internationalized domain names and the forms, and also what are the unique challenges when, for example, and which is called universal acceptance that you're referred to, but the unique challenges is, for example, if you have an email ID in Telugu and you're trying to reach somebody on Gmail, will that mail reach? Will there be a problem at the server level where the mail may not reach? So those kinds of challenges were discussed. Our experts, were there in the room, and those were discussed. And several next steps with that community, which IMAI is kind of bringing to the table or brought to the table. Next steps have been discussed as to what might happen into developing better systems so that Indic languages get on the DNS as soon as possible. There's one more event, in fact, I apologize, I didn't mention it earlier. It took place on the 4th. It was related purely on security, and that was hosted by the Data Security Council of India, which is part of NASSCOM. ICERT, which is Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, which is part of Ministry of Electronics and IT. And that event, we had IT security experts in the room, both from India as well as international, part of the ICANN community, who again talked about some of the key issues that Indian ISPs are facing in terms of security, and how to mitigate those issues and what needs to be done. So I'll just stop here. I'll be happy to take more questions later, but this is just to give you a summary of some of the key discussions specific to Indian stakeholders which were held at ICANN 57.
Thank you, Samir. I'm T. Santosh, scientist E in Ministry of Electronics and IT. Namaskar. At the outset, I, on behalf of Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Government of India, would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude at the opportunity to host the ICANN 57 meeting in Hyderabad, India. We are indeed delighted that the historic ICANN meeting subsequent to the INA transition happened in the beautiful city of Hyderabad. It gives us immense pleasure to inform you that 3,158 participants checked in for this present meeting. Also happy that 365 sessions during the 7 days were conducted at this momentous meeting on the PDP, that is policy development process post the INA transition. Coming to Indian participation, at previous ICANN meetings, since this is the 57th meeting, so all other meetings, usually there is an estimate of only 20 to 25 people attending this ICANN meeting. At present, the information provided by GRO, it has been said that around 1,052 participants from India, highest number in the history of ICANN, has participated. That too actively participated. This indeed is a remarkable moment, as we believe that this would provide the much needed impetus to other Indian stakeholders to emerge as a significant contributor to the ongoing discourse in the area of internet governance. Now, I would also take this opportunity to thank the government of Telangana for the two outreach program which was provided to the GAC members. GAC is Government Advisory Committee of ICANN, out of which there are 170 government from different countries who have visited Telangana Hub, Internet School of Business. And today, two people have visited, they are on the way to Digital Village. Thank you for that, Government of Telangana. And also, I would like to thank NICI, that is National Internet Exchange of India, for the constant support and guidance in making this ICANN 57 successful. I also thank there are five attached offices as well as autonomous body of our ministry, NIC, STQC, CDAC, STP and CMET for providing the support at Hyderabad. In the end, I thank each one of you for making this event such a huge success.